Hey everyone, welcome to Geekettes Chat. I am Shirley.
Hey mi gente, I'm Christy.
And we are here to review, Julie and the Phantoms, which is a teen musical comedy drama on Netflix. And yeah, we're here to review it and we're gonna have fun. It's 9 episodes. And come along and watch. So basically the plot is, it starts with a teenager named Julie, and I think this is in California. My bad. And she's trying to find her passion for music. Her mom passed away, and basically she meets these ghosts who appear to her in her garage of her house. And it's a trio of ghostly guys who were in a band, and I guess they have unfinished business. It was created by Dan Cross and David Heigl? I think that's his name. I'm sorry if I'm messing it up. And so we wanted to talk about with the executive producer, because Kevin Ortega, because he's Mexican-American, right? And Christy's going to bring up all the stuff he's done.
Right. Okay. So, musicals. I'm a huge fan of musicals. So this show, although it's geared towards teen audience
and children
and kids, yeah. I totally loved it because it's a musical. And so Kevin Ortega, who did High School Musical for Disney, which it was very popular back in the day, and I actually enjoyed High School Musical, but I think that this one is so much better. He also did Hocus Pocus, and then my all-time favorite, Newsies, which is when I fell in love with musicals. I love Newsies. I love you, Ortega, for doing Newsies and this show, because it just made me so happy watching it. But let's get more into depth. He also choreographed Ferris Bueller's Day Off Dirty Dancing. So this guy is multi-talented.
And he is talented,
So he's directed a couple of episodes, but he's the executive producer and he was very involved in the project.
Mm-hmm. It seems like it, having seen Newsies and Hocus Pocus and the first High School Musical. Yeah. I didn't see the other two. I think it's two.
So stay tuned because we're going to be talking a lot about the show and it's pretty awesome.
Yeah, so the cast involves Julie Molina's the lead, of course, actress, her Madison Reyes, and then the band members is Luke, which is Charlie Gillespie, Alex, who's the drummer, Owen Patrick Joyer, then there's Reggie, who's the bass player, and is Jeremy Shada. Sorry about that, you know me and Nate. And then Julie's best friend is Flynn, who I really appreciated the most. Jada Marie. And then Carlos Ponce plays the dad, Ray Molina. And, you know, Carlos Ponce, we know him from, like, telenovelas. And we were like, oh, he's in this? Okay.
He's a singer and an actor.
I mean, he's been in American movies, but we've seen him mostly in telenovelas, basically.
So what's great about this show, it has a little cultural aspect. So the Molina family is Puerto Rican, really.
Right.
Right.
Yeah, yes.
And so the Reyes is Afro-Latina. She's Puerto Rican. So it's awesome to see that aspect in the show.
And then there's her aunt.
And her aunt.
Allison Areya, who's the sister of the mom who's passed away. We don't meet the mom, of course, because she's dead. And then there's the little brother, Sonny Bustamonte. Carlos Molina, he's the younger brother. He's cute too. And the music is by David Lawrence. And full disclosure, I don't like musicals. I don't like singing and dancing.
Beg her to watch the show. I was like, Shirley, if you're watching for, because the music is so good. So
no, the music, okay, I'll tell you two. Okay. I like the band. The band was so cute. The guys, the girl, the lead actress was amazing. She was so good as a singer and as a performer, and her best friend, you know, I like I already said, I already appreciate her. I was like, she was the hype man. She was, and she's so talented. She was doing multicast things, like, you know, being the hype person and then the DJ and all that stuff. And their costuming was so cute.
It was adorable.
It was just the singing and dance, and the songs were good. They were actually good. It's just for me, singing and dancing, it's just so hard to get into for me. Like, I went to go see Happy Feet with my friends when I was in high school, and I literally sat there was like, when are they gonna stop singing and dancing? Like, that's just my thing. It's just like, it's just, I don't know what it is. I can't, like, I don't really gravitate to it.
Oh, Happy Feet is not a good example because I love musicals and
no,
I
really enjoy. No, but here's the thing though. Happy Feet wasn't actually a bad movie. And I would say this about this show, going ahead. I think it's better than the High School Musical. I only saw the first one. I think it's better acting wise and better, like, all that stuff with the singing and dancing. Yeah, yeah. Sorry.
And I think it's the acting. Yeah, definitely the acting is really good here. And I think it was because they built the chemistry before they even started the show when they were,
wow.
Rehearsing and auditioning for the band. They actually built the chemistry together. And so I think it comes out great on screen. And I think that's the most entertaining part of the show.
The chemistry
between the band. They're like a family. And it's cute little tidbits that I've read here and there about the band, how they, you know, when they were auditioning, they came together in the circle. Uh-huh. And they acted like a real band, which was so cute.
That's cute.
I think that comes across in the screen so well. Like, even Ortega was, like, telling the band that to see him as a partner in the show. And I think that's how they saw each other, really.
Yeah. With Kevin Ortega, I like Newsies fine, Hocus Pocus fine. I'm not, like, in love with those two movies, especially Hocus Pocus. I don't understand the love affair with it, but that's okay. Again, film is subjective. I love things that other people probably don't love, and that's okay. But they're fine. With this, I think this is the thing I like most from him. I mean, he's a producer, so it's like executive producer. But again, it was really cute. There was, like I said, the costume was really cute. They acted like teenagers. The music was actually really good.
And I just want to mention something about the music. These actors actually are performers and musical performers. Julie sings. She plays music. They all, even Reggie, the character Jeremy Shada, he's actually in a real band. It's called Make Out Monday. We're going to link it below, a sample video of their music. And so they're real musicians and they came together to do
and you,
the show.
And you and felt you that felt chemistry that, yeah. Even before when you start in the beginning. They died like 25 years, like in 1995, 25 years before, I guess, where the show is set, this year or 2019. Yeah, so their band is Sunset Curve, and in even then when you see them perform in the beginning, you see that chemistry and like the music and how it like comes through, and but then Julie brings this fire when they come together later on, and it's like that's the interesting aspects that I liked from the show. And then there's of course the kid stuff, the teen stuff, the ending. The ending was really like kind of like for me iffy. I was like, huh? It was just like it was just like a switch of like, oh right,
the tone in the show.
The tone of the show that it you know, for me, I have to remember this is not for me in a sense. Like, this is a teen kids show. And you always have to, like, remember that, you know. And so there were some aspects where I was like, oh, right. This is for, you know, for teens and for children. Like, I can't, like, I have to have a different mindset about that. Because there were some things where I was just like, huh? But, and again, with the singing, dancing, you know me, I don't like that stuff, so, yeah.
But
it was still really fun. It was still really fun, and I say if you like it, and you like that, again, the chemistry is what really hooked me, and, like, the story with Luke's mom. I don't know, this is a spoiler, if you want to
We're going into spoiler territory, but it's not so much of a spoiler, but there is this episode where Luke and Julie goes to visit Luke's mom, who...
Because she found this song that he wrote, and he thought she thought it was for a girl, but it was actually a song for his mom, which I thought was cute. And I was like, oh, that's different, because most of the time
it's songs definitely for, different. So that's what I liked about this
song. It's called episode. Emily, right? That was the mom's... Yeah. Unsaid Emily, I think.
Unsaid Emily. It's such an emotional episode. I cried, and so many people who watched the that episode cried as well.
That was
so
crying. That actually
I thought that that was the best touch for the show, because it was such on a more... a lighter, fair thing, although you can kind of tell the loss and grief that Julie has experienced because of her mother, and how when the band comes, she gets this new enlightenment for music and passion grows from that. So the show is very aspirational and inspiring more than anything else. So
yeah, I think I wish we got thing. More from the mother, because I know she's the one that's empowering, I guess, her in a sense of like what she can do like by herself as a singer, and not only just depend on the guys, because they kind of disappoint her a little bit in the beginning. But they're there for her in the end, of course. I wish we got more of the touch of who her mom was. Not like a flashback, but who her mom was. I guess with season, if they make a season two, if that happens, then they'll go into it a little bit more. Because I don't even know if they ever said the mom's name. Did they?
In the beginning, I think that was the mom's name. I mean, the mom. They show the mom.
Well, yeah, I think
they said her name, but I'm not going to say it now.
Oh, okay. I remember that was the mom. I was the one that told you. I think that's the mom or something like that. And you were like, oh, really?
But back to this, Julie's relationship was with the dad.
Was cute. Carlos Ponce is still cute.
I love Carlos Ponce. I've seen him in a couple of novellas. He's so good. I liked him. And I felt like
I liked him here more than the novellas.
His acting here really complimented Julie's acting in a way. So
he was so supportive of her.
Very, you know, you could kind of tell when actors have this chemistry and they kind of feed off of each other. And I felt like that I saw that between her and her dad. And just the fact that he was so supportive was a nice...
That's nice.
Was something really nice to add to the storyline.
Your parents were so supportive.
Because whereas in... the opposite of where Luke's parents weren't supportive of his career to become a musician, so that duality was nice to see in the show.
And then the having the regrets, what ifs, and then giving that the song, Julie giving that song to her, the mom and stuff, and I guess that was closure. I thought that was
really I'm gonna link the Unsaid Emily song down below.
She's in love with that song.
Because that's my favorite song. But before we go, I really want to play a sample of one of their openers in the show, and so that you can hear it. But they have so many good songs. This is one.
Doubting myself, I feel like I needed some help. Stuck in my head. With nothing
left.
I'm gonna say the Nick storyline, and the Nick who's the boy that she likes, and the girlfriend. The Nick's girlfriend, who's the main bully that doesn't like Julie, they used to be best friends. I think her name's Claire. I didn't like none of their songs that she sang with her band or whatever she was.
I think that was intentionally done.
Dirty Candy. Like something like that. And I was like, every time she sang and like did stuff, and I was like,
girly band type.
Yeah, that was I did not like the storyline was with. I liked Willie. Willie was so cute. Him and Alex, that was really cute.
Yeah.
Willie's one of the ghosts that Alex meets. And through Willie, they meet the main bad guy.
Yeah.
And again, I have to remember, this is a children teen show. But I did not like that
the
story.
Villain.
The villain. Or his singing and dancing is not bad. He's good. It's just that, again, you know, it wasn't my thing.
I felt like it kind of...
But I get it. They needed something.
Yeah.
They needed something to... So I'm not like,
I didn't think it didn't bother me so much, because I'm trying to, remember that it's a teen show and it's kind of, it's geared towards teens.
Right.
But it did feel like it kind of broke the tone a little bit when he came into the show.
For me, yeah.
Very.
But again, I
get it. Because his role is so theatrical, whereas I felt like the rest of the characters weren't. But then again, I don't know. So let's see how that plays out in the next one.
Yeah.
In the next season, which I hope they come with a season two. Because I would literally like a season two.
Yeah.
I want to hear more Reggie and Alex singing. And I want to see.
Yeah, they had good voices.
The building of Willie and Alex's relationship.
They were cute.
Which was so adorable. Like, it was so innocent and so playful. And I really liked it.
The Luke and Julie relationship. Oh. Let's see how they work that out.
Yeah, because it's leaning towards something of a, like, yeah. She's,
you know,
starting
a crush
on him more.
You know how
and
I
Luke
feel
is,
about
And Luke is a cutie, so I could see
I
that.
I don't know.
But I always felt like they had this, they have a really strong bond because of the music.
The music.
I think they have chemistry
when they're singing.
Yeah.
I don't know how I feel about them becoming a couple. I don't know. I'm not really.
I don't know how that could look because she's gonna be dating a ghost. But then this is 2020, so anything is possible.
If they work it fine, then great. I'll buy it. But right now, I'm like,
anything is possible in 2020. We're in a pandemic right now, so a ghost and a real life girl dating, I can probably see that. And now they can touch. So who knows what's gonna happen. Oops, that was a spoiler. But anyways,
she's seen Casper too much. That was a cute movie. Casper was good.
I love Casper.
Casper's a cute movie.
Adorable.
I like the show. It's cute too. The show's cute.
I want to give props to both Julie, the actress Reyes, and Luke, Madison. Charlie. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Madison and Charlie, who actually wrote a song throughout the production that ended up being in the show. It's called Perfect Harmony.
Wow.
It's a really good song. So you can tell these characters are like real musicians. They actually wrote a song for the show. And then Kevin Ortega put it in because he liked it so much.
He's like, these are talented kids. So, are they all kids? Or teenagers?
They were teenagers. I think now Charlie is an adult. But
Okay.
When they filmed it, I think.
Closer to age than some of them.
Some other shows.
Some other shows.
Oh, anyways.
Glee.
Glee.
Like 30-year-olds. check it out if you like musicals, teen, children shows. It's a cute show.
Even just for the music.
The music is so good. Chemistry between the actors, which was really cute and interesting. So, yeah, definitely.
Oh, yeah.
So,
thank you for watching.
Thank you for watching. Subscribe, like, write down what other things, shows, or books, or comic books. Because we're going to get into that a little bit more.
And if you know anyone who likes films or likes watching reviews or anything like that, please share our channel with them. Thank you.
Please.
Thank you. It's so awesome. Peace out.